Right. So in this class I am going to discuss exponents, as I said, and the exponents is a basic mathematical part which requires, as I said, basic knowledge related to the algebra. And now in exponents we have different categories: exponents with natural indices, exponents with integral indices, exponents with rational indices, all these things and different types of problems we will discuss in these classes. And what is meant by index, what is meant by exponent, all these things I will mention as a first point of exponents. Everything I will give you as a points, you need to maintain that points properly. Okay, first point of exponents, I will start with addition. See, we all know addition as well subtraction. Subtraction is basically the opposite work of addition. See, basically addition is what? For suppose if I will say 3 plus 4 is equals to 7 is addition, we all know it, right? And from that addition, multiplication is developed, and division is the opposite process of multiplication, and multiplication is repeated addition. Okay, multiplication is repeated addition. See, basically always mathematics simplifies our work. If you feel any difficulty or discomfort in completing a work, then in that position mathematics gives us a logical idea to simplify that work. In that order of simplifying our usual work and lifestyle, mathematics develops different concepts: addition to multiplication, multiplication to exponents, all these things. Okay, multiplication is basically repeated addition. For suppose one person has 3 rupees, other person has 4 rupees, then the total amount with them as 3 plus 4 7 rupees, that is easy. Whereas in other case, there are some 40 students in a class and every student has 3 rupees, then what you say about the total amount? See, how many students are there in the class? 40 students. Every student has how much amount? 3 rupees. Then what is the total amount? See, if you go with the addition, 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, like that we need to add. Okay, so that is simply nothing but multiplication. Adding 3, 3, 3, like that 40 times. Addition of 3 for 40 times is simply nothing but multiplication, which is 3 into 40, and your answer is 120. So instead of doing addition repeatedly for many times, you just go with multiplication. That means multiplication is what? Repeated addition. In the same way, from multiplication we are just developing exponents. So exponents is simply nothing but repeated multiplication. Multiplication is repeated addition, whereas exponents is repeated multiplication. In one word, if you wish to say about exponent, which is nothing but repeated multiplication. If you wish to multiply one value repeatedly, then there occurs the concept of exponents. So 3 into 3 into 3 into and so on into 3. If you multiply it for 40 times, repeatedly multiplying 3 for 40 times is generally notated and represented as 3 power 40. Okay, so this is basically the concept of exponent. And as I said, subtraction is the opposite work of addition, division is the opposite work of multiplication. In the same way, the opposite work of exponent is simply nothing but the concept of nth roots as well as the concept of logarithms. Okay, right. See, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, all these things you already learnt in our previous classes. And so now I am concentrating on exponents, and from that exponents we will discuss some problems and some concepts related to the nth roots and logarithms is in some other class. Okay, okay, logarithms you will learn in the further classes. In this class, in this program, we are just learning exponents and nth roots, right? And basically exponent is simply nothing but repeated multiplication. Okay, so for suppose if you wish to multiply 3 for 40 times, which is generally notated as 3 power 40. That is the basic idea of exponents, and then I will give you different terms and definitions related to the exponents in 1b. You just take all these things as 1a. Okay, first point, and in that a is the subject. Okay, yes.
Sir,
make a note.
Go for a screenshot.
So exponent is repeated multiplication. You just mark all these things as 1a. Now 1b. As I said, exponent is repeated multiplication. So for suppose, as I said, 3 into 3 into 3. I am just multiplying 3 repeatedly for 4 times. How many times? Just I am multiplying 3 for 4 times, which is simply nothing but 3 power 4. And the value, see, 3 into 3 is 9, 9 into 3 is 27, 27 into 3 is 81. The value is exponent. The value of that exponent is 81. See, writing like this, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 for 4 times or for 40 times as per the requirement, is usually called as product form. Is mentioned as product form or sometimes mentioned as expanded form. And this 3 power 4 is exponent. This 3 power 4 is considered as exponent. And this 81 is mentioned as value of exponent. Okay, everybody just pay attention. Okay, this 81 is value of exponent and this 3 power 4 is exponent, whereas writing the 3 power 4 as a product of 3 for 4 times is the product form. Okay, and what to say about this 3 and what to say about that 4? This 3 power 4, that notation is exponent, whereas this 3 is considered as base. Okay, in this 3 power 4, this 3 is considered as base of the exponent. This 4 is considered as power or index of the exponent. Power or index of the exponent. In another word, see, exponent is repeated multiplication. The number which we are using for repeated multiplication is considered as base, and the number of times that base is used is mentioned as power or index of the exponent. Here we are multiplying 3 for 4 times. Since we are using 3 repeatedly for 4 times, this 3 is considered as base of the exponent and that 4 is considered as power of the exponent. Always we need to maintain a difference between that base and the exponent. Okay, just have a look. For suppose, if we have another thing like 7 into 7 into 7 into and so on into 7, 100 times. Here we are multiplying 7 for 100 times. So we will write it like 7 power 100, that is the exponential form. And we don't know the value of that 7 power 100. See, because it's a bit difficult to multiply 7 for 100 times, you just need it. No need to mention the value of the exponent always. If it is simple, you just calculate it and mention. Okay? If it is somewhat difficult to calculate the value, you just leave it and your answer is 7 power 100. And in this process of expressing that 7 power 100 as an exponent, we are using 7 repeatedly. That 7 is the base and 100 is the power of the exponent. That's it. Have a look. So, as I said, if you multiply 7 for 100 times, it is 7 power 100. 7 is the base and 100 is the power. Okay? See, be perfect in identifying base and the power. Okay? Which number we are using for multiplication is considered as base. And the number, how many times we are using, is considered as power. Okay? I will mention you for suppose 5 into 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 5. Here I am using 5 for 8 times. So I will write it like 5 power 8. Value of the exponent is your choice. Okay? If you are able, just find it. Otherwise, leave it. This 5 is the base and 8 is the index or power or x. Okay? And this 5 power 8 is considered as what? Exponent. We will read it as 5 power 8. Okay? Notation is this and we will read it as 5 power 8. 5 is the base and 8 is the index or power. Okay? And for suppose, just look here. I am using 3 power 4 into 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 3 power 4. How we will write? Here, 3 power 4 is a number. Okay, its value is 81. You just keep it aside. 3 power 4 is a number. And I am using the 3 power 4 repeatedly for how many times? For 6 times. Since I am using 3 power 4 repeatedly for 6 times, I need to write it like this. 3 power 4 to the power 6. What it is? 3 power 4 to the power 6. If you observe this 3 power 4 to the power 6, in this, what you say about the power? Power is 6. And what you say about the base? Base is 3 power 4. You just observe that notation. Okay? Power is 6 and base is 3 power 4. Why? Because we are repeatedly multiplying 3 power 4 for 6 times. Since we are repeatedly multiplying 3 power 4, that 3 power 4 is the base, and we multiplied it for 6 times and power is the 6. Is it clear? Okay, so pay attention on the number which we are using for multiplication. Okay, first suppose I have x square into and so on into x square for 1000 times. How can we express? We are multiplying x square for 1000 times. So x square to the power 1000 is the notation. See, that simplification is the other thing. First of all, x square to the power 1000 is the notation. And here, power or index is 1000. Whereas, base is what? X square. X square is the base. In another way, first suppose if you multiply x, I am just mentioning here. First suppose, if you multiply x into, and so on into x. How many times I am multiplying x here? For suppose if I am multiplying x for 2 power 1000 times. How many times? 2 power 1000 times. I don't know the value of 2 power 1000. I am just giving you the notation. If you multiply x for 2 power 1000 times, then you have to write it like x power 2 power 1000. See here, the base is what? For this, base is equals to x, whereas power is equals to 2 power 1000. There is a difference between this bit and that bit. Okay? You just observe here. For this problem, we are just multiplying x square into x square for how many times? 1000 times. And so we are writing it like x square to the power 1000. Whereas coming to this case, here we are multiplying just x. How many times? 2 power 1000 times. Since we are multiplying x for 2 power 1000 times, this x number which we are using for multiplication, x, that x is considered as base, and the number of times we are multiplying, 2 power 1000 is considered as power. So this is x power 2 power 1000. There is a difference between this x square to the power 1000 and x power 2 power 1000. Okay, you need to identify the difference. You need to think about this product form. In this product form, which number we are using for repeated multiplication, that is considered as base, and the number of times we are using, that is considered as power. Okay, I think this is clear. Okay, don't get any confused, okay? Right, I will discuss different problems in some other points, okay? Just here I am mentioning you about the base and the power. Be perfect in identifying base and power by observing the product form. Okay, and after that, I will give you different problems in these formats. From there, we will easily identify base and power, all those things. Okay, first of all, you just think about that product form. In that product form, observe the number which we are using for multiplication, observe the number how many times we are multiplying. Okay, I will give you another simple problem. Okay, just look here. First suppose x power 7 into x power 7 into x power 7 into and so on into x power 7. See, I am multiplying x power 7 repeatedly. How many times I am multiplying? I am multiplying this x power 7 repeatedly for suppose 5 power 6 times. I don't know the value of 5 power 6, okay? But I am just multiplying x power 7 for 5 power 6 times. Then what you say about the answer? See, here we are multiplying x power 7 repeatedly. So, for sure by observing this product form, I will say that this is x power 7. And since we are multiplying it for 5 power 6 times, then here the power is 5 power 6. Since the base is x power 7 and the power is 5 power 6, we need to write it like this. Base is x power 7, power is 5 power 6, and this is the exponential notation for this product form. And simplifying this exponential notation will come with different laws, and I will discuss it in the next point. First of all, have a look. Identifying base and the power. Okay? Right. So, to solve different numerical problems of exponents, we need bit knowledge related to the powers of exponents. Okay? You just try to practice the powers of exponents. For suppose if you say 2 power 1, I will mention you afterwards about 2 power 0, okay? 2 power 1, the value is how much? We are multiplying 2 for 1 times, 2 power 1 is just 2, that is equals to 2. And what you say about 2 square? Multiplication of 2 for 2 times, that is 4. And what is 2 cube? Multiplication of 2 for 3 times, that is 2 cube, which is equals to 8. Then what you say about 2 power 4? Multiplication of 2 for 4 times, that is just simply 16. Likewise, you need to think about the powers of different numbers. Okay, 2 power 4 is 16. In the same way, if you calculate, 2 power 5 is 32, 2 power 6 is 64, 2 power 7 is 128, 2 power 8 is 256, 2 power 9 is 512, 2 power 10 is 1024. Okay, after this class, you just make a list of all these things. This is about 2 powers. And then you just think about 3 powers. 3 power 1, 3 square, 3 cube, 3 power 4, 3 power 5 and 3 power 6. Just at least up to 3 power 6 and 3 power 7 you need to memorize. 3 power 1 is 3, 3 square is 9, 3 cube is 27, 81, 243, like that you need to mention. And after that you just calculate and memorize the values for 4 up to 4 power 6 and 5 just at least up to 5 power 5. For 6, at least up to 6 power 7. For 7, and up to 7 power 4. And for 8, at least up to 8 power 4, like that. You just calculate all these values, memorize all these values, 9 power 1 and then up to 9 cube. Okay? So, if you memorize all these values helps us in calculating and in solving different problems related to the exponents easily. Okay? So, this is just 1C. You just list out all these values and I will ask you the values in the next class. Okay, I will select one of you and I will ask you the values in the next class. Right, just observe this and then you need to list out the values of all these things. So, second point is about laws of exponents. There are some laws, or you may say them as properties, which helps us to solve the problems, and I will just mention you the basic laws here. Okay. Laws of exponents, right? And 2a, first law. See, the law is very simple. For suppose if I have 3 power 4 into 3 power 5, what it means? 3 power 4 into 3 power 5. 3 power 4 is simply multiplication of 3 for 4 times, okay? 3 power 4 is 3 into 3 into 3 for 4 times, whereas 3 power 5 is multiplication of 3 for 5 times. Yeah. This is multiplication of 3 for 4 times, that is multiplication of 3 for 5 times. If you multiply all together, there are totally 4 and 5, 9 times we need to multiply 3. Multiplication of 3 for 9 times is simply represented as 3 power 9, and you just express this 9 as a sum of 4 and 5. So 3 power 4 plus 5. So 3 power 4 into 3 power 5 is 3 power 4 plus 5. So this is usually called as the product rule of the exponent, and at the end I will mention you like this: 3 power 4 into 3 power 5 is equals to 3 power 4 plus 5. If you generalize it, what will happen? If you generalize it, a power m into a power n is equals to a power m plus n. A power m into a power n is equals to a power m plus n. You just observe this. If you have the product of two exponents with the same base and different powers. I am just again saying, See, if you have the product of two exponents with the same base and different powers, as a result, you need to add the powers with the same base. The base should be same everywhere. And if you have multiplication sign in between the two exponents, as a result, the power is simply the sum of the powers. Okay? A power m into a power n is equals to a power m plus n. We have a chance to extend this idea. Extending this idea in the sense, for suppose if you have a power m into a power n into a power p, then I will write it like a power m plus p. Not only two exponents, any number of exponents with the same base with multiplication sign in between them, to get the answer, to get the result, you need to add the powers. Okay? I will give you another problem. For suppose if I have 7 power 4 into 7 power 5 into 7 power 17 into 7 power 24. What is the answer? 7 power 4 into 7 power 5 into 7 power 17 into 7 power 24. Here just I am multiplying exponents with the same base 7 and with different powers. 4, 5, 17 and 24. As per this product rule, this is simply represented as 7 power 4 plus 5 plus 17 plus 24. We need to add all the powers. And if you add, what will happen? 4 plus 5 is how much? 9. 17 plus 9 is 26. 26 and 24 is 15. And your answer is 7 power 15. Okay. So, to express the product of different exponents directly in the form of exponent, this product rule helps. At the end, you need to memorize this a power m into a power n as a power m plus n, and that rule, its extension, everything we will use in solving different problems. Okay, just have a look, make a note, go with the screenshot. Right, I am just realizing. Okay, right. B is just an extension of this product rule again. We just develop B with this A power M plus N. Just have a look. Loss of exponents. A is A power M into A power N is equals to A power M plus N. I mentioned you different examples also. And B. See, B bit is like this. For suppose if I have 3 power 4 to the power 5. 3 power 4 to the power 5. As I said, 3 power 4 to the power 5 is simply nothing but, here 3 power 4 is the base and 5 is the power. We need to multiply 3 power 4 for 5 times. 3 power 4 into 3 power 4 into 3 power 4 for time, 5 times. As we discussed in A, all these exponents have same base with the product in between them. We need to add the powers. 3 power 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. Because there are 5, 3 power 4, we need to add 4 for 5 times. So that is equals to 3 power 4 into 5. Since we are just adding 4 repeatedly for 5 times, which is 3 power 4 into 5. At the end, you just observe this 3 power 4 to the power 5 and this 3 power 4 into 5. Okay? See, if you generalize this idea, we will have that a power m to the power n is simply nothing but multiplication of a power m for n times. Multiplication of a power m for n times, if you express it like this and after adding the powers, your answer is a power mn. You just have a look, very useful idea. A power m to the power n is simply nothing but a power mn. Okay, for suppose if you have a problem like this, 7 power 4 to the power 12, what is its answer? 7 power 4 into 12, and we will write it like 7 power 48. Okay, see, this bracket makes that magic. We need to multiply these two just because of this particular law. Okay, for suppose if I have like this 2 power 3 to the power 4 and whole to the power 5. So we have, there is a chance to extend this idea. 2 power 3, power 4, power 5. First of all, this total 2 power 3 is one quantity and 4 into 5 we need to do. That is equals to 2 power 3 to the power 4 into 5. That is equals to 2 power 3 to the power 20. And then again use the same logic. a power m to the power n is a power m into n. So 2 power 3 to the power 20 is simply nothing but 2 power 3 into 20, which is 6. Okay, just have a look. A power m to the power n is equals to a power m. Okay, see, as I said, you need to think. Okay, you need to think once and twice while listening. Listening is just not enough to learn. So, okay, learning is a combination of listening along with the thinking. Okay, just have a look. First law of the exponent is a power m into a power n is a power m plus n, whereas the second law is a power m to the power n is simply nothing but a power mn, as I said. And I mentioned you two simple examples also, right? Again, have a look, make a note, and go with the screenshot. So, laws of exponents. First law is a power m into a power n is a power m plus n, whereas the second law is a power m to the power n is a power mn. Whereas coming to the third law, which we call it as quotient law, what I will mention here is, first suppose 7 power 9 divided by 7 power 4. How to express the answer? Again, in the form of exponent. 7 power 9 is simply nothing but multiplication of 7 for 9 times, right? 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. Multiplication of 7 for 9 times and divided by, and the denominator is 7 power 4. Here we need to multiply 7 for 4 times. Everybody just keep a, have a look, okay? Pay attention here. The numerator and the denominator are two exponents, and those two exponents are with the same base. Are with the same base, okay? If base is same for both numerator and denominator, which are in exponent form, in that case this law helps us much, okay? Here 7 power 9, okay? Multiplication of 7 power 9 times, and the denominator is multiplication of 7 power 4 times, and we know divisions, okay? And we know, yeah, the dividing these type of problems. 7 and 7 gets cancelled, 7 and 7 gets cancelled, one more 7, another 7. Like that, if you cancel out 4 7s, then you left with 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. Because 4 7s gets cancelled, we left with 5 7s, and we are multiplying 7 for 5 times, and we need to write it in exponent form as 7 power 5. And I will express this power 5 in terms of 9 and 4, which is simply nothing but 7 power 9 minus 4. At the end, you just observe this given left side part, which is 7 power 9 divided by 7 power 4, and this answer, which is 7 power 9 minus 4. Okay, always if you have the division or quotient of two exponents which are having same base, directly you need to write the answer with the same base along with the difference of these powers as a power of the answer. Okay, and if I generalize it, as a law of exponent, we need to memorize a power m divided by a power n is equals to a power m minus n is the quotient law of exponents. This is again very useful law. Okay, in many cases we use it. For suppose if I have a problem like this, 7 power 2021 divided by 7 power 2019, then what is your answer? See, usually it is a bit difficult to write in this format. Writing 7 for 2021 times, writing 7 power 2019 times, and again we need to cancel out, then you left with only 2 2's. But according to this law, the power of the numerator is 2021. First of all, we need to check whether these two exponents are with the same base or not. Yeah, numerator is of same base 7, denominator is also of base 7. Or you may wish just change the base, 17 and 17, no problem. Numerator base is 17, denominator base is 17. Powers are different. Okay? And write it like this: 17 to the power 2021 minus 2019. Because the power of the numerator is 2021 and the power of the denominator is 2019. So this is equals to 17 to the power 2021 minus 2019 is simply 2. So your answer is 17 square. And 17 square value is 289, multiplying 17 with 17 itself. Okay. So while answering these type of problems, this law helps us much. Basically, laws of exponents are very useful in solving many problems of this exponents. The first law is a power m into a power n is a power m plus n. and the second basic law is a power n to the power n is a power m n, and the third basic law is a power m by a power n is equals to a power m minus n. There are many laws in exponents, and we consider these three laws as the basic laws of exponents. Just have a look, make a note, go with screenshot. Next bit is D. Here I need to calculate the value of anything to the power 0, and specifically a to the power 0. See, actually, as I said, a power n is simply nothing but multiplication of a for n times. This is the basic definition of exponent as we discussed. But that means we need to multiply this a for n times. But if I say a power 0, multiplication of a for 0 times is meaningless actually. Multiplication of a for 0 times is meaningless actually. But since we are discussing exponents, okay, we need to use this a power m by a power n is equals to a power m minus n just to notate the value of a power 0. Okay, a power 0, right? I will write this a power 0 as a power m minus m. Is there anything wrong? M minus m is 0, right? And this a power m minus m can be written as a power m divided by a power m just with this basic law of exponent. Because m minus n, a power m by a power m, n is also m, okay? And the numerator and denominator is same, you will get it as 1. That in a sense we need to conclude that a power 0 is equals to 1. See, just mean as a notation we need to accept this a power 0 as 1 just to satisfy this law always. Okay, if you won't accept a power 0 as 1, this law also fails. Actually, a power 0 is meaningless. Multiplication of a for 0 times. But as a multiplicative identity, see, everything is just with the multiplication, right? 1 is the multiplicative identity we know from the number system. So, to exist that multiplicative identity again in the exponents as well, just with the help of this law, we notated, we observed, we calculated the value of a power 0 as 1. So, next law of exponent is simply a power 0 and that is equals to 1. Anything to the power 0 is equals to 1. Except a not equals to 0. Anything to the power 0 is 1, but 0 power 0 is meaningless. Because multiplication of 0